Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Hereafter you can watch my website on Artiflex engine, nitrogen generator, solar power by just clicking on the icon on the YouTube channel on the right hand side. Okay, today my topic is pressure transmitter defects. So today I'll be explaining you how you are going to check the pressure transmitter. Right now we get an alarm here. We have a composite boiler and auxiliary boiler here. So suddenly we get an alarm. Ship is running and we got a pressure in the composite boiler. But in actual scenario, the pressure in the computer showing -3.99. So it's showing an alarm, low pressure. But actually the boiler, composite boiler, we have a pressure of 6 bar on the actual pressure gauge. So I will be explaining you how we are going to check the defects. So this is the computer where you get the alarm. So you can see the pressure here, 6 bar showing on the line. So what we are having is we get a defect alarms and you get a failure here. This is the steam pressure controller. You have FAIL, fail. If you see the manual of this, this defects is not shown in the manual of the Aalborg. So I will be explaining you how to identify what is the defect here. So next what I am going to do is we will be opening this controller, steam pressure controller, and checking what is the fault. So we check through the parameters what they were given. This FAIL is not there. So but anyhow, I will be explaining you how you find the defects in this problem. So you need to open this controller and take it to the workshop. We got other controllers also here. So what we usually do is, this is the pressure transmitter here. From this pressure transmitter we will get an 4 to 20 milliamps. From here the signal will go to the controller. You can see the right now the pressure is here, around 6.8 bar pressure. Actual pressure is here. So now the problem is find out whether this transmitter is defective or not, or if the transmitter is good, then why the signal is not coming. So I'll be explaining you regarding this. So what we're going to do is we will remove the transmitter and check how to check the transmitter. I'll be explaining you in detail. So what we are going to do is remove the transmitter in place and check whether it is working or not. So what I have done is I have removed the transmitter. So this is the loop calibrator. I have explained you how you are going to use the loop calibrator. You have to get the internal and external output is here. Right now I will be connecting it to show you the transmitter is working or not. So what you have to do is, one connection I already connected to red. I am just touching the other one. You can see it showing 3.92 milliamps. So it's 4 milliamps it's showing. So if I remove it, it goes off, you can see here. So that means this pressure transmitter is okay. But to make sure that it's working, what I will do is I will just blow air by the mouth and you can see the milliamps will increase. So if you, what I'm doing is, what I'm trying to show you is, I'm trying to blow by mouth to show you the reading should increase here. If it is increasing, that means the pressure transmitter is working all right. So you can see the reading is going up. When he removes, the readings come down. So the transmitter is okay. So next what I want to tell you is, this is the controller here. We have 220 volts can be given here, and we have the diagrams. You can see here the pressure transmitter has to be connected here, through which we will be getting 4 to 20 milliamps, which will be, again you'll get the signal on the controller. So there are other connections also in the controller which I'm not going to explain, but I'm only particular about the pressure transmitter, pressure signal here. So what I'm going to show you is, this controller we have removed from place. This is the box over here, you can see here. This we have removed. Then we'll be checking whether this is working or not. In our case, what happened was it was showing FAIL, fail. And we found out that when the pressure transmitter was given, it was not showing signal because the control voltage was not coming into the controller. I will be explaining you regarding that. You should know to read the drawing. So what we did, we checked the thing. Now after that, we are putting the controller back, and we will be given, we will be checking, giving the controls. If you see here, we have got the relay boxes here. So the relay which is coming for the controller, we have removed it, and we exchange it with the other relay of the other circuit. If you see, what I am doing is I am removing the relay from here, and this is, and changing the relay from here to the other one. Once you do that, you can see this is signals coming, and you are able to, this is the relay. We'll be examining on the relay why it's not working. Now once I put the relay, you can see the pressure showing 5.8 bar. So if you have any message regarding this, you can always let me know. So I hope it will be useful. Thank you.